In this Q&A video, we'll be answering the question, what are the individual parts of equipment complying with BSEN 60309 called? This question relates to the video that Gordon and Gary made on the Proxima socket outlet from Scame. It's a very well made piece of kit, and it comes in possibly the most over-engineered piece of packaging that we've ever seen for electrical equipment. But it certainly gives a sense of occasion to installation work. Feels like I've just won some kind of major sporting event or something. Anyway, check out that video for a full review of some of the great details on this product after watching this video. But turning our attention to the question for this video, one of the things that grates on me a little bit as an electrician and a teacher is when people call one of these a plug. Can I charge my phone up, please? Certainly, there's a plug just in the corner there. And then 30 minutes of exposition on the history of the socket outlet later, I'm the unreasonable one being asked to leave. According to the judge. So let's condense that down and outline the correct terminology for devices that conform to BSEN 60309. First of all, we've got an example from Scame in the form of the Proxima range, and this is the socket or socket outlet. The electrical supply is connected into the back of here, and it's waiting to receive a connection. Into the socket outlet goes the plug. This is the only part of the system that should be referred to as a plug, even though in a moment we'll look at something remarkably similar to it. When I was an apprentice, the chap that I worked with, who was probably the best electrician that I've ever known, used to refer to this connection as a gazinter and this one as a gazonter, because this goes into that and that goes onto that. Pretty sure that they weren't the technical terms. Then, if what we're connecting is an extension lead, then on the other end of that, there will be a device that we may be tempted to refer to as a socket again, because it's got a gazonter type connection. It's got these hollow tubes in there for us to connect to, and it looks like it will receive a plug. So is this a socket? Nope, it's called a connector. The reason it's not called a socket is that it's connected to the end of a lead rather than part of the fixed electrical installation. So a fine point, but one that could save confusion when ordering online or down at the wholesalers. The final part of the system that we'll identify in this video is rather an odd one, and I'd argue slightly more specialist than the other items. Again, at first glance, it looks like a plug because it has pins, but it's actually referred to as an inlet. You can see that it's not designed to be connected to the end of a lead, but rather it fixes to a piece of equipment, so it would be suitable for things that need to be moved around. For example, you'll find them on the outside of caravans, and in the distant past, I installed them on the control panels of machines that were designed to make sections of concrete flooring, and we called them appliance connectors back in those days. So there we go, those are the names for the different components complying with BSEN 60309. But things don't always get called the right name, so we'd like to hear from you. Do you have different names for these items? Do you have slang names for electrical things that are unique to you and the people you work with? Or are you an absolute stickler for calling things by the right name? Please leave your thoughts and any questions you may have in the comments section below, and as always, thank you very much for watching.